Hey guys, Ashley here. Today I'm doing another journaling video. It is a mini flip through. Mini because it's small. If you saw my last journaling video, you would have seen that I did my Seoul page because in October of last year, I went to Seoul, South Korea and just kind of documented that whole traveling little story time experience. And a lot of you guys seem to like that. So I thought I would show you the rest of the spreads that I completed for the rest of the time spent in Seoul. Planning this a trip to Seoul, very last minute. If you watched my Seoul vlog, it is called a spontaneous trip to Seoul because it was very spontaneous. That involved a lot of purchasing things online last minute, which leads me to bite and say that this video is being happily sponsored by Dashlane. Thank you, Dashlane. If you don't know what Dashlane is, so they are a free app available across all devices and platforms where you can basically store all this information, and it's so helpful. So you can store your passwords, etc., all the things. And it makes online shopping super smooth and easy. Basically, you store all your information. You just press a button and it automatically fills it out. So if you don't have a wallet and you need to buy a concert ticket and it's like, shoot, what do I do? Oh, press a thing and it fills it out automatically for you. I've been using it a lot lately. It is comeback season, bitches. It is a time. Concert is upon us. So I have been using it to buy so many various concert tickets. See you there. Woohoo. And the cool thing about Dashlane is that it is actually free on your first device, but they do have a premium option, which allows you to be on multiple devices. And so that is where I come in. Hello, friends. If you use my link in the description, you will automatically get a 30-day free trial of premium. No credit card required. So get on that. Use the link. Use Dashlane. It has made my life so much easier with purchasing things. You know you want to. Comeback is here. There's lots of books to buy. There's a lot of albums to buy. Get it. That way, if you're trying to beat hoes in the ticket line, you don't even have to fill in that credit card information. You just boom, hit it. I'm trashy. But yes, thank you so much, Dashlane, for sponsoring this video. I hope a lot of you guys try it out and, you know, can fulfill your concert buying wishes or travel wishes. Go to Seoul. Okay, back to journaling. So the first spread I completed is my boy with love spread, which is when I visited the house of BTS, which is just wonderful. And it was their pop-up shop in Seoul. It was limited. It is there no longer. So I was one of the first to experience that. Fun. So on the spread, I really like it. I went for this like pinky aesthetic. So right here I have the map, which is the floor layout of the actual shop. It was three stories and just aesthetic pink dreamness of BTS basically. And then my code, and then the items I bought. And for some reason, I did put the wand and how much it costs. Yeah, don't look at that. Very expensive. I spent way too much money. The House of BTS in general, I think it was totally worth it. Everything about it was really great. However, it was really long in line. The wait was insane. Hence why I have this little army bomb friend that says, "We love a 6-hour long wait," because I actually did wait for 6 hours. Yeah, no joke. 6 hours. I got there at 6 in the morning and didn't get inside until 12 o'clock because there was just that many people and it was freezing. Ah! I also did a little couple of army selka days with my friend Kaylee because, you know, they were there and we were there and I bought the same things, and you know, that is what an army selka day is. So yay! Oh, more money I spent. But yeah, House of BTS, an awesome experience. Very pricey, very long wait, but I enjoyed my time there. It was great. Ooh, next page. I really like this spread, how it came out. I'm going with a weird bubble theme, like using these little round stickers as bubbles. I don't know what's going on there, but that is what that is. But yeah, it was super cool and it was very interactive. Like there are different levels you could go on and certain rooms that had to do with certain music videos. Obviously one of them being Boy of Love, and this was the Army Bomb Forest. It was just a great general time and I could stay in there forever. Like you just feel in a place and they play music all day and you bop and you feel happy. It's a great time. So my next place is still a continuation of that, which was one of their themed rooms. And yay, and this was actually one of the cards I got from the House of BTS, which is like a little postcard I just decided to use the envelope to decorate with. I also bought one of their sticker packs. The thing about this was that things sold out so quickly, so you got in a queue and then you wrote down what you want, but you weren't necessarily guaranteed those items even though you paid for them already. I got there in certain sticker packs, they were like, oop, we sold out before we could give it to you. And I was like, oh, great. I love that for me. Also, explaining this little thing, skirts warning zone. So this little picture here is in another one of their little interactive rooms. And when you went in there, it changed colors. The walls were like playing DNA. It was a funky galaxy time. But on the outside, it said skirts warning zone. Like, what the hell does that mean? What is that? What are you trying to insinuate here? I don't understand. But yeah, I really like this page. I liked how it turned out. It's really cute. We have their little mini baby figures that they had there. Very nice. Okay, moving on to this page. So after waiting 6 hours in the freezing cold, of course, a bitch was hungry. She was hungry. And you know, conveniently, they definitely planned this. Laundry Pizza was right down the street from the pop-up shop. And if you don't know what Laundry Pizza is, it is a pizza place. Wow, surprise shocker there. But they have done multiple various photo shoots there. A lot of idols, their groups take photos there. Specifically, boys, the boy, they have done their shoot there. This is taken from one of their albums from the Love Yourself era, and this was one of the photo cards. It's that whole pizza shoot. That is where this is. So this was just my time there in Laundry Pizza. I was kind of a hoe when I took some selfies because feeling like a hot bitch. But pizza was very good. Also, the line there was also very long because, like I said, everyone from the pop-up shop was just traveling to the pizza shop. And that is what's happening. I also included this little, on that same day we went shopping afterwards and I went to SPOW, which is probably like the equivalent of like a Forever 21. It's just a little simple page of me and June, you know. We're matching in pizzas. Yay. I try to do an army silk a day with Jin, but honestly, like, that boy, I cannot. He just sits there and does nothing, and if I do that, I look ugly. So I just took selfies instead. Yay. And of course, we have some eggs falling. And it is a new day. This was a new day. Woo. So on this day, on this page, I kind of just made it about, like, sights I saw in Seoul. Hashtag Seoul views. So over here on the first spread, I have the Hello My 20th House, which is one of my favorite dramas I saw last year. Binged the heck out of it. Love it so much. It gives me really emotional. And you can actually go to this house, which I believe in real life is a type of like cafe, healing cafe type of thing. You can have a foot spa bath type of situation. It's really great. So I went to that. And let me tell you, seeing that was like really weird deja vu, even though obviously it's fake and I don't live there. But I've so watched the show so many times. I was like, I'm home with my girls. Like, please give me a group of girlfriends in our 20s so we can move in here, please. Ah. And then the funny thing about this is, so like everything around there is real. Like when they film down the street, it is real. It's the exact same. And you see that building right over there? Conveniently, do you know what it was? It was freaking KQ Entertainment. Hello, where are my A-teenies at? Like, I didn't even know that was behind there. I just happened to stumble upon this and I was like, hello, KQ Entertainment? Hello? Hello, hello. So that's that. I took a picture of it and I walked by and I was like, okay, I have passed by the presence where greatness has been formed. Stan. Yay. And then here's some more sights in Seoul, which are just some of the street views, which is so pretty. Love it. More street views. This is a card I got from a dessert place where I had nice tea and they have cake, but we didn't eat any cake. And the whole trip, we were like, we really need to eat that cake, but we never got that cake. That is a cake story you didn't ask for. Next page is the SM page. This was all done on the same day and I freaking love this. Okay, so if you don't know what SM Town is, they are obviously SM Entertainment and it's located inside the Coex Starfield Mall and it's basically where SM Entertainment is and as well as a museum and shop. So honestly, being a NCT stan, this was a lot of fun craziness for me. Here is the museum tickets, which I find extremely amusing and funny. It's just what it says. Like, take a look at the history of SM artists from their debut by albums, costumes, and props. Also learn how SM contents are produced. Enjoy a special and fun time just for you with your favorite artists through augmented reality. Like, this is just some weird, like, sounds like some weird dystopian crap. I mean, it's SM, so like, tea. But yeah, so here's Taeyang Woo! Look, he's like a little sprout because, you know, grass fam. So this was a ticket from SM Town. When you went inside, you could customize your own stamp. So I did SM Town Live. Jaehyun's under here because he is the bias and he's saying 92%. I'm not a weirdo, I swear. So like this little thing, it says hand matching. You could go to this machine and put your hands in and then it would tell you your compatibility. Like this is some stupid teen catered shit, but you know, I definitely did that. We are 92% compatible, lifelong soulmates, obviously. So he's just under there for like secrecy, like, hello, it's my soulmate. Ooh, some funny story about that is, so I have this another little picture over here. It is of 10, Jaehyun, Winwin, and Mark. And yeah, why is 10 blocked out? So when you're doing this hand compatibility thing, you could swipe to pick a member. This hose did my boy 10 so dirty, because Jaehyun is a 127 bias, but 10 is like the ult. They did him so dirty. They freaking don't even have him there. He's just this gray augmented figure. Rude. So dirty. So rude. It is rude. But walking through this was a really fun experience. I definitely recommend if you are a fan or even if you're not a fan. It's just a cool thing to look at. They have a bunch of archives and every album ever if you want to look through it. And each room is like decorated to a theme of all the groups. It was a fun time. Here's another part of the brochure. Also the shop. I spent way too much money in the shop. It's fine. Here's one of the things I got, which is a little sticker. It came in a sticker pack for NCT, which is a lot of their like Touch and Boss era stickers, which I am here for. Like I said, it was in Coex Mall, so they have that famous little library there. Very pretty. Oh, fun fact, when I went, it was Winwin's birthday, so hello, let me take him out. Oh, woo! You know how SM feels about Winwin, but it was his birthday, so upstairs on the third level, I believe, they have a little food cafe, which just has a bunch of cool food-themed items based on all the members. But all these girls, lovely, they had these little free photo cards for Happy Winwin Day. So that is just in there. But the SM Museum was so cool. Like, they actually have a lot of their outfits from music videos, like Cherry Bomb. It was very cool to see. I want to go back because I believe they do change out the actual displays and like content they sell in the SM store based on what era is happening. So for example, NCT, they just had Superhuman that past year, so that was the era they were going back to. Hopefully when I go back to Korea, their newest comeback will be there and that will be exciting. So yay. I really like how this page turned out. At first I was like eh about it, but like I'm feeling it. I'm digging the vibes. Yay, SM. All right, next, I traveled to the North Seoul Tower on a different day, and which is just basically like observatory type of deal. Like if you can see here, this was a view from my freaking bathroom. They have these really cool bathrooms way up high when you're thousands of feet in the air, but the wall to the right of you as you're peeing is completely a window, so you can just look at the view as you pee. What a great bathroom experience. Wow. So this is just my ticket. This was me. It says drink H2O bish and says post meth feelings because I literally felt like shit going up that freaking hill to go to this tower. And it says drink H2O because that is not what I did, and I got extremely dehydrated and gross and I felt horrible and it was a horrible experience, but I did feel better at the end, which was worth it when we finally got up there. But ooh, drink your water, kids. Hydrate or dehydrate, as they say. If you go to the top of the Seoul Tower, it's super beautiful. Scenery is super nice. It has a lot of nature and trees. But also, it's known for because it has all these love locks along the entirety of the railing. So Kaylee and I, of course, made one ourselves. It says the date and it says soulmates. Like, get it? Like, soulmates. Because we're soulmates, but like soulmates. And I really like that, and it's all lovey-dovey and nice, and it's really pretty. I highly recommend there if you want to go with a loved one or a friend or just yourself to enjoy the views. It was very nice. So on our last day, we didn't do much because we had an early flight. There was nothing open in the morning, but you know what was open? Line Friends, which we totally hadn't been to millions of times already on that trip. They had a cafe specifically in the Itaewon one, which was literally a 5-minute walk from our Airbnb. The character-themed drinks, you get a free sticker when you get a drink. I had tried cookies. I would have gotten RJ's, but I think it had coffee or some type of like chocolatey situation happening there, and I don't like chocolate or coffee, so unfortunately could not, you know, honor the boy. This line, friends, is really cool because it's actually the specific one where they filmed those YouTube videos. Like, you could sit there, and there's pictures of them sitting there. It's a great, fun time. But yay! All right, guys, that is it for my journaling video. Show off all the vibes of this trip, and I hope you got a sense of what that was like through my awkward talking. Woo! Thank you so much for watching. Let me know in the comments what you thought of this type of video, like a mini flip through story time thing. If you have any questions about Seoul, feel free to ask. I would love to answer. All right, guys, my name is Ashley. This is Ashley Outpaged, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!